telling me that she didn't name a successor. Then it's mine. I'm a son. The Lord goes to me.
I'm sorry, Willis, but that's not so.
She had to name someone, and she didn't. So now it goes to a vote.
Bullshit. The leadership goes to me.
Can't this kind of talk wait for another day?
It belongs to me, you hear? It's mine. I'm the new Papaloa.
We told you that couldn't be.
Not unless we vote you in.
Well, let me tell you something, bitch. I am the rightful heir, and there ain't no way, no way, that you gonna keep it from me. You in trouble, Lisa. You're all in trouble, and you gonna know it. Don't nobody turn they back on Big Willis. Especially you. If my mama hadn't have taken you off the street, you'd still be peddling, you jive-ass bitch.
One time, if I ever catch you even thinking about Lisa, anybody else here in this room, your ass is mine. Dig it?
Right, brother. Right. You good people, take care, you hear? Be seen.
And when we vote, we're voting for Lisa.
Voodoo priests have too much power. I too swore revenge. I swore one day they would pay for having me dethroned.
What is it?
Bones. Bones that's powerful enough to revenge all past indignities. Must be careful, for this is power beyond all common man.
I ain't afraid of no power.
Good. Good. This is all you need to know. Take it!
Thank you.
la vie. Prenez ces eaux comme le feu soit fini. Nous nous débarrasserons de nos soucis mortels. Le feu emporte la mort et la vie. Prenez ces œufs. Et la soit finie. Du sang bien rouge pour te rendre fidèle. Nous nos soucis. Le feu emporte la mort et la vie. Renaît. Ranimez ces eaux comme la lutte soit finie. Le feu emporte la mort et la vie. Ranimez ces eaux comme la lutte soit finie. Le feu emporte la mort et la vie. Ranimez ces eaux comme la lutte soit finie. La vie, tout son bien rouge pour te rendre fidèle. Nous nous débarrasserons et nos soucis mortels. Le feu emporte la mort et la vie. Prenez ses yeux comme un lac soit fini. Le feu.
What do I do?
Hey, Blood.
What do I do?
Hey, what's this, man? What's going on, man? I can't see myself. You got something to do with this, man?
I'm afraid that's one of the misfortunes of the cursed.
Oh, man, you jiving. Hey, look here, man. You mean to tell me I ain't never gonna see my face again? Hey, look, man, I don't mind being a vampire and all that shit, but this really ain't him. I mean, a man has got to see his face. Shit. I don't even know if I want to go now. Can't even see myself. How do I look, man?
You were going somewhere?
Yeah. Justin's having a big party. He's showing off his African collection.
African?
Yeah, dude's brought back all kind of stuff. Sculpting, jewelry. Come on, man, tell me the truth. It's important. How do I look?
You decided to go?
Well, you know, I might as well. Anyway, my old lady's gonna be there, and she gonna get dead in my case if I ain't there. So look, you have a nice evening, and I'll see you later.
You go nowhere! Now listen to me carefully. You're never to leave this house without my permission. Your only justification for crawling on this earth is to serve me. Understand me well. If you ever dare to disobey, I will slice into your chest and pull your worthless life out.
Right.
A curse of suffering on you that will doom you to a living hell. A hunger, a wild, gnawing, animal hunger will grow in you. A hunger for human blood. I curse you with my name. You shall be Blackula.
place looks deserted.
The owner's on vacation.
Leave it to Willis to get himself a soft job.
Hey, Willis!
Willis? Willis, it's us, Elaine and Lewis. Maybe he's already gone.
No, he knew we were coming to pick him up.
This place gives me the creeps.
Look around down here. I'm going upstairs.
Alone? Hello?
Hey, Willis? Hey, man, you there? Elaine!
Nobody's there anymore. No one's around to hold you. You feel so all alone.
Well, I've got the love you need. My answer is a lot of clear. You don't need to look no further. Call on me. Hotline.
You say you need touch. Nobody's there. You grow. No one's around to touch you. You can't go all alone.
Hey, Daddy! Hey, Daddy, I've been looking all over for you. Hey,
what's with that long face?
Oh, Willis should have been here an hour ago. Honey, judging from what I heard happened between him and Justin this morning, ain't nobody named Willis showing up at this party.
This isn't it.
It's beautiful.
Exquisite. The Niger Dynasty produced so many fine artifacts.
Ibani.
I beg your pardon?
The necklace is of the Ibani Dynasty.
We appreciate your concern, sir, but I believe you're mistaken.
Hardly. It was fashioned in 1755. This necklace was worn by the Princess Luva. Do you have the matching necklace?
No, I didn't know there was one.
Oh, yes. The other was made for her husband, a prince of the Ibani tribe. Oh, 1,000 pardons. I didn't mean to intrude, but I was out walking and the happy sounds attracted me.
Not at all. I think it's terrific. Are you sure about those dates and things?
Yes.
Hey, that's great. I'm happy to have you here. I'm Justin Carter.
Jumbo, I'm called Mamuwalde.
Mama Walde, Miss Lisa Fortier.
Mademoiselle Fortier.
Professor Walston, African Studies, Ropes and University.
Nimafurahi, sana kwa kukuna.
Lafia, it's my pleasure. What part of Africa are you from?
The Segu River region, just north of the Niger Delta. I really must compliment you on your collection. It's just splendid.
Thanks. It's a good one.
Justin has donated the collection to the University Museum.
I'm very happy.
Well, the party's sort of an official goodbye.
I see. Tell me, have you any more pieces from the Segu River region?
Yeah, there are, as a matter of fact. Would you like to take a look at some of them?
I'd be most pleased to, thank you.
Lisa, why don't you show Mamualdi around?
Now, with such a lovely guide, I'm afraid I'd lose my concentration on the artwork.
How about that?
I do believe you know what he's talking about.
Interesting dude.
If I give you warm, will you give me cold? If I want to stay, will you believe in me? If I tell the truth, would you tell me lies? If I try a knot, will you be slipping out? Will I find you tripping out? Hey, mystery man! If I play it straight, will you? Will you go for laughs? If I order wine, will you be buying it? If I ask for speed, will you ask for slow? If I show I care, will you be walking out? Is that what it's all about? Hey, mystery man, why make me guess? Do you want no? Do you want yes? Give me an answer. If I give you laughs, will you give me tears? If I play your game, will you be cheating me? If I give you love, will you give me hate? If I name a date, will you be shutting down? Will I find you cutting down? Hey, mystery man.
An historian or a dealer in African antiquities?
Neither. Merely a devoted amateur. All things African interest me.
What do you do?
Actually, I'm retired.
Pretty young to be retired.
Very kind, but I'm afraid I'm considerably older than I appear. Why do you stare?
I feel we've met before.
Oh, if we had, I would not have forgotten.
Lisa, Justin's asking for you. I think he needs some help.
Thanks, Danny.
Sure.
Excuse me.
But of course.
Hi.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
That's kind of strange looking, isn't it?
It's rather unusual. Perhaps you can help me.
Sure, what is it?
What exactly is this doll? It looks familiar, but I can't quite...
Well, you know it's a voodoo doll.
Yes.
Well, I think this one has to do with evil spirits. I'm not sure, though. You should ask Lisa. She might know.
Might know? You gotta be kidding. When it comes to voodoo, Lisa has more natural power than anyone in the last 10 years.
Really? So the Mamaloa virtually adopted you.
At 17, you don't get adopted. Anyway, I'd hate to think of where I might be if she hadn't taken an interest in me.
Now you're being much too modest. I've been informed that you have exceptional powers in the exceedingly complex science of voodoo.
Science? I never thought of it that way. To us, voodoo is simply a religion based on faith. A powerful, powerful faith.
Is it true, then, that under proper circumstances, you can control the inner being and change its destiny? You're staring again.
I'm sorry.
Is something wrong?
I don't know.
Oh, my goodness.
It's my fault, Ben.
Oh,
it's my stupid fault.
On that.
Oh, how bad is it? Oh,
it'll be
bad
all right.
Enough.
It'll be all right.
Oh, Maggie, there's a first aid kit in the upstairs bathroom. I'll join you in a minute. Would you excuse me?
Well, I must be leaving myself.
Oh, must you? It'll only take a minute.
Yes, I must go. I thank you very, very much for a lovely evening.
Will we be seeing you again?
Oh, yes, indeed you will. And a good night to you. Mr. Carter.
Mama Waldy. Justin, please.
Thank you. I'm afraid the wine has made me somewhat weary.
Well, I do hope you've enjoyed yourself.
Very much, thank you.
Mama Waldy, I've acquired some ancient African jewelry. And I was wondering if you could come by some time and help me figure where it came from.
Oh, I'd be delighted.
How about tomorrow afternoon?
Evening would prove better for me. I'm rather a night person. I have an awful habit of sleeping away the daylight hours.
Well, it is done. Thank you.
Okay. Good night.
How's Gloria?
She's fine. It's just a small cut. Maggie's with her.
All right, I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Okay. All right, good night. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Tell me that you can. Listen and you know, babe. I've got to have you. Every time I hear your voice, a thrill runs through my soul. Every time you even breathe, I lose my self-control.
But brother, I still think you missed the force.
Professor, let me tell you something. My publishing firm in 1 month makes more than the entire police department makes in 1 year. Now, do you still think I dig the force?
Every time I hear your sighs, I know I will fall. Gloria!
evening.
Want some company?
I beg your pardon?
I said, do you want some company? Forget it.
What is it we got here? Don't you dig our merchandise?
What's the matter, man? Don't you dig girls? Or is that the reason for the cape?
It sure is a sweet-looking thing.
Hey, man, with threads like that, it figures you've got to be loaded, right?
So, why don't you pass some this way, brother?
Hey, faggot!
We're talking to you.
What is it you want?
What is it you want? Shit.
Your bread, man. All of it.
Are we gonna have to become antisocial and kick your ass? You dig?
I'm sorry, I don't have any bread with me. And as for kicking my ass, I strongly recommend that you give it careful consideration before trying.
You jive, mother. Either you give it up or we're gonna take it out on your black ass.
You made a slave of your sister. You're still slaves, imitating your slave masters.
Hey, sucker.
I've always considered myself a reasonable man. Now, my thinking may be a little prejudiced due to race, creed, and color, but then again, none of us are perfect. Anyway, I'm gonna give you the benefit of my friendship with Justin here.
Harlan, what the hell are you talking about? How can you even consider Lisa as a possible suspect?
Because this girl's murder tonight is not a normal murder. And if you ask me, the voodoo freaks had something to do with it.
Harley, man, we are tired.
Lisa, I know you people never talk of your voodoo, so I won't bother asking you questions pertaining to it. But there are certain characteristics generic to your religion that even the lay person knows. Allow me to mention two of the most obvious.
Harley.
Now, one is snakes. Even the uninitiated knows that snakes to voodooists are like cows to Hindus. Two, and this one's disgusting.
Harley.
Two, you guys drink blood. Now, this girl's body had two snake-like puncture marks on its throat. And said body was completely drained of blood. Completely drained of blood. Now, if that doesn't add up to voodoo, I don't know what does.
Justin, do I have to sit here and listen to this crap?
Hey, look, just take it easy now. Pull yourself together.
Harley, I admit those were strange-looking marks, man. And I know you're down on her thing, but you don't have to get sloppy about it.
Lisa, what's this between you and Willis? I hear he's out to get you.
I have nothing against Willis.
Man, why don't you bring him in here and ask him?
I will.
If you need any help, give me a call.
Oh, you think I'm gonna need it?
Mm-hmm.
The worst detective I've ever had, and he wants to help. I'm amazed I didn't throw him off the force long before he quit.
Yo. For you.
Damn. Can you believe it? Same thing. No blood and the same stupid-looking marks.
Civic 31 clear.
1389, no one on the
surface. Hey, Justin. I need your help.
Okay, come on, people, move it out.
Let's go, let's go. All right, keep moving.
How'd you find me?
Ex-detective. Remember?
What's wrong?
Those killings last night. The cause of death was identical to Gloria's.
What's going on?
Lisa, I've got to find out as much as I can about the cult. Now the lieutenant is looking to bring you in as a suspect. I want to prevent that.
The lieutenant is crazy. He's out to get me.
Thank you. Look, honey, I told him that I would talk with you. I gotta find out as much as I can about your membership in the cult. Are there any vendettas going on, grudges, anything like that?
As far as I know, no one had it in for Gloria, or for anyone for that matter. The only grudge, if you want to call it that, is the one Willis might have for me. But I don't see how killing Gloria and those two guys would give him any satisfaction.
Unless he wants to break up the cult.
Yeah.
Hey, you know something? If anything ever happened to you, I'd just blow the whole thing. What's happening tonight?
I've been asked to sit with Gloria's body.
Willis? Willis, if your black ass is here, you better not let me see it, because I'll bust it in two.
Hey, Mama.
Mama, oh, Mama, you son of a bitch. Why are you scaring me like this? Keeping me waiting?
Come on, girl.
You did it on purpose.
Slow down.
Well, where have you been the past few days? Why are you hiding from me?
Willis ain't hiding, baby. Look here, he's been working overtime. Hey. Just relax. Yeah. Come on, let me get a good feel of those bones. Yeah.
I missed you.
Hey, these bones are tense, baby.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, come on. Willis is gonna do something to work all that out for you, okay? Yeah.
What you doing?
These bones are tight.
Well, what you gonna do about that?
Big Willis is gonna have to do something to relax your entire body.
You think you know just how to get to me, don't you?
I can feel the blood just humming through this fine body.
Take it easy. Willis, you're hurting me. Where did you get them teeth? Take that crap out your mouth. Willis, stop it now. Stop it now, Willis. Stop it, I mean it, stop it. Willis!
That's it. Come on. Lisa.
Gloria.
Hello, Lisa. I won't hurt you. You're my friend.
Fear me.
Stay away. Who are you?
Lisa.
Gloria. What happened to Gloria?
You would never understand. I'm moved by powers no human is capable of comprehending. The things I do, the acts I commit, are beyond my control.
Where did you come from?
Fire that gave me life.
Fire. Then I knew I'd seen you. The other night, rising through flames.
Lisa, through voodoo, you possess a great power. Great power. I must ask your help. I need your help. Lisa, I must see you again.
Gloria, what happened to Gloria?
Please, you must let me see you again. I'll make everything clear to you then. Issue a warning. You all know Lisa Fortier. She is under my protection. Not one of you shall harm her. This is a commandment. And if one of you disobeys, you will never imagine the pain I offer. Unendurable, everlasting agony. Now, leave me. You are foul. Your face is sickening on me.
Oh, I gotta tell you, babe, you sure know how to live.
Hey, you know, the way I look at it, if that jive mother leaves Big Willis alone, Willis gonna leave him alone, baby.
Now you talking, honey. You just ignore his ass.
Hey, but you know one thing, though?
What's that?
That skinny ass Lisa, that bitch is gonna fall under my wrath. Not directly, mind you, but surreptitiously, you dig?
Yeah, I believe it. Then you wanna know something else?
What's that, baby?
She deserves whatever you give her.
Hey, and she gonna get it all.
I never did like that bitch.
Oh, badass Blackula come telling us to lay off of her. But no matter what, I'm gonna get back at that bitch. She did too big a number on me to let her get off that easy.
Yeah, well, what you gonna do to her, sugar?
I'm waiting. I'm waiting on the inspiration. But it's got to be something special.
You dare.
Oh, shit. Hey! What's happening, man?
You were warned.
Warned about what?
That nothing should ever happen to Lisa.
Lisa? Who's gonna harm Lisa? I love that bitch.
Hey, what right you got coming in here bothering us?
Hey, baby, cool it.
I heard about you. You just stay on your side of the house.
Hey, Denny.
Well, you just gonna let him bully you around?
Hey, man. Don't mind her. She means well.
Well, what are you looking at?
Hey, Denny.
Now, look, I'm not taking any more of this shit, Willis. I mean, whose house is this, yours or his? Listen, you, if you...
Now you be thankful that I've chosen not to rip out your worthless heart. Very shortly, I shall bring Lisa Fortier here. I shall designate a quiet room, which you are to arrange according to her instructions. Once we enter that room, there'll be no interruptions. If you allow any violation of that commandment.
Fry.
What is it?
Damnest thing I've ever seen. Bat pelage.
What the hell is bat pelage?
Hair is from the skin of a bat.
Bat? What kind of a bat?
I don't know. Actually, we've never seen one like this before. It could be a new species.
Let's see. This is it, this whole shelf. Black arts, occult. That should keep you busy for a while?
Yeah.
Vampires? Are you out of your mind?
Probably, but I'd still like to look into it.
Well, you think you can prove there's a vampire? Let's see, just a minute.
Hey, Charlie!
Yeah?
You know who killed that girl and those two punks?
No, who?
A vampire!
Charlie's our expert in everything.
Harley, are you through having your fun? Now, I didn't say I can prove it, but let's give the theory a shot. Bat hairs, bodies drained of blood, one even disappeared. Now, you can't ignore the possibility.
Oh, Justin.
Well, look, have you talked to Willis yet?
Lieutenant? Excuse me.
Hey, hi, Justin. There's something strange here.
What?
Now, these are the pictures we took of the dead bodies, and there's no sign of them. It's as if they were never there.
Now, what the hell does this mean?
Here, let me see that.
Well, maybe the film is faulty.
It's impossible. Everything else came out in those pictures.
Okay, Milt.
Hey, Harley, this backs me up. Everybody knows that vampires can't be photographed. Now, every 10-year-old knows that.
Ah. Oh, you're making me nervous. Sergeant Williams! You want me to do something? Williams!
Harley, I want you to get permission for me to look at one of those bodies, and I want you to come with me.
No.
Harley.
No!
Yes, Lieutenant?
Get someone over to the Anderson place and bring Willis Daniels in.
Right.
You really mean it, don't you?
Will you do it?
Oh, I'm really getting to dislike you.
Would you care for some wine?
Oh, not a thing, thank you. Ah, I see you're interested in folklore.
Yeah, I've been on sort of a kick lately. Been reading all sorts of junk like this.
Junk?
Well, you've got to admit that this stuff is pretty far out. You believe in any of it? Occults, rituals?
Let me say that, I believe there are many things that exist that man does not know about. Man needs ritual, some form of worship to combat the very real existence of death. I look upon that as one of man's basic needs.
Well, I go along with that. But I've got to tell you, I'm a born cynic. I finished this one book and it had...
You ever hear of Count Dracula?
Yes, of course.
Vampire, right? Well, this book tried to make me believe that he really existed. And not only that, it tried to convince me that vampires are real.
That's fascinating. Well, I guess we'd both best be careful that one doesn't jump out at us some dark night.
Says to kill one, a wooden stake must be driven through its heart.
I wonder if that's true.
I wonder.
I've always loved the deep red color of a fine wine.
It is beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, much like the deep red color of blood.
Yes. I think I will have a little glass after all.
You know, you never told me where you were staying.
You know, you've never asked.
Where are you staying?
Do you really care to know?
Why not?
Justin, rather than give you information of no consequence, allow me to offer you some rather profound advice. Forget your theories. Return these books to their shelves. Because if there's one thing you should have discovered in your studies, it is that the intelligence of man is pathetically inadequate when pitted against the forces of the unknown. A man comes face to face with a vampire, most surely be at its mercy.
I believe a vampire is responsible for the recent killings in this town.
Then you believe in vampires. Good. That gives you something of an edge over the rest.
I'm going to find him. And I'm going to do whatever's necessary to kill him.
Justin, I hope you have good luck and find nothing. Because if you're right, and these unfortunate deaths are indeed the work of a vampire, who knows who will be its next helpless victim? Now I must go. Do have a good night.
I'm frightened. For the first time in my life, I'm frightened. All my life, I feared nothing. And now you tell me what you are. And I accept it. Completely, without question. I'm afraid.
You mustn't be. No harm can come to you.
But
I have no choice. My only alternative is to destroy myself. Alisa, I know that voodoo, in the proper hands, can unlock many mysteries. Yours is a power unlike mine. It can be used for good as well as evil. Now, if I were back home with my people, they would understand me and forgive me. Therefore, I ask that you help me return to my homeland by exorcising this demonic creature that inhabits my body. Yes. You must try. There's no other way. You're my only hope.
I'll try.
Police. We'd like to have a word with Lisa Fortier. Lisa Fortier?
Yes.
May we come in?
No, what do you want?
The lieutenant wants to talk to you, ma'am.
We have a warrant.
I advise you to let the lady go.
Who are you? You better stay out of this, mister.
I implore you, for the last time, leave her alone and leave this house.
Listen, buddy, we got a warrant. You know what a warrant is? Now you stay out of this, or I'll lock your uppity black ass up for...
Are you all right?
Yes.
No, I think you're going to need a little more than an empty coffin to convince me of vampires, wouldn't you say?
Harley, just think of what's happened. The two punks, Glorious, both bodies drained of blood.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but Harley, that means something. What about the photographs?
Oh, for Christ's sake, I don't know.
Look, give me the benefit of the doubt, okay?
Now, look, don't get nervous, but I had my men pick Lisa up.
What?
For own protection, just in case. Hey, what are your clients are missing?
Lieutenant?
Yeah?
What? When? The two of them?
Maldición sua dispietra. Maldición sua dispietra.
You all know what to look for. Whoever finds the girl, get her out of there right away.
Hey, Harley! Harley! Come here!
Look, why don't you have every man to get one of these?
Hey, Justin, don't you think that's a...
Please, man, trust me.
Well, go ahead, take them. Come on.
Lieutenant, don't you think this is a little ridiculous?
Go on, take one and shut up.
Please, you mustn't be frightened.
Stay away.
Please. I could never harm you.
Don't touch me!
But you've got to help me. No, don't refuse me now. I need you.
Keep away!
Thank you.
I lived in endless empty space, so alone, so lonely. Knowing there was no one I could touch, no one touching me. How could I face even one more night? How could I go? I live in darkness, never light, so alone, so lonely. Knowing that I cared for no one else, and no one cared for me. How could I face even one more moon? How could I go? In peace instead of torment. I lived in hope, not in hell, so in me, so wanting. Hoping that in you there was a power to end the search for my soul, a power that would give me freedom.
Thank you.